I'm Ryan Gandy with Fish and Wildlife Research Institute's Shellfish Research and Monitoring Program. Oyster resources worldwide are actually in decline. The Gulf Coast was once considered one of the areas of the world that still had good densities and abundance of oysters. However, studies that were done around 2010 showed that oyster resources in the Gulf of Mexico have been in severe decline in recent decades. After the Deepwater Horizon oil spill, there was a lot of funding that has gone into oysters for restoration and to try to get oyster resources back to some of what they formerly were. One of those projects is our habitat suitability indices, which is a model that you feed information like temperature and salinity and mapping data where oysters are, and it tells you within that area where oysters may have a better chance of survival in the long term. But the components that go into it are pretty interesting in that oysters, even though they're well known, people identify with oysters, they're something people love to consume, they're actually very data poor in a lot of areas of the Gulf. And so this project specifically focusing on four regions of Florida, the Panhandle, the Big Bend, Tampa Bay, and Charlotte Harbor, is looking to fill the data gaps that will help populate a habitat suitability model. And some of the components of that are, one, looking at the historic data in each of those regions that was available and putting together trends to look at what that resource has done over time. The other part of that is updating maps of oyster bars and developing more fine-tuned maps that allow us to identify changes in oyster resources over time through either satellite imagery or subtidal mapping of those. The other component of this is filling in data gaps where there may be ongoing monitoring projects in different regions through either estuary programs or NGOs, and working with those colleagues to increase the amount of sampling going on in the area, as well as in areas where there is no monitoring, to begin to do some baseline monitoring and to be able to validate some of the maps that are being developed. And then that all culminates, those all become components of this habitat suitability model that we're looking to develop. There are some already existing in the different estuaries around Florida. So in those areas, we're just looking to support the agencies that are there, provide them more data. In areas where those don't exist, we're looking to develop, one, a new model for the area, but two, that are transferable so that they are based in a system where any of the municipalities can pick up the program and be able to run it in something that's an open source platform like R. So that's really the goal of this, is to have more resources available for those restorations. It also helps support a second phase of this funding source, which is a large-scale restoration in one of these regions based on the information we've been able to gather.